Competition is fierce in the Kardashian-Jenner household, and it ain't stopping anytime soon. Sure, they all love each other, but let's be real. We want to know who does what better, right?
Right.
There is nothing as fun as dueling sisters, and we're here to see the most famous family in the world versus each other. The Kardashian trio versus the two younger Jenners. Kim may have brought the whole family to worldwide fame after her leaked viral tape with Ray J in 2003, which ultimately led to a reality series that literally swept the nation and, well, the entire world. But since then, each sister has walked her own path with class and style. So let's see which set of sisters take home the cake. Let the games begin. Early beginnings. The older of the sister groups are the trio we all know and love, Kim, Courtney, and Khloe, coming from Kris's first marriage to the famed lawyer Rob Kardashian. So this family had always been more or less known once their father took on his friend O.J. Simpson's case in the 90s. This essentially drew the family in polar opposite directions. A very long story short, Kris and Rob split in 1991, the same year that she married Bruce, now Caitlyn Jenner. The Kardashian trio was rather unknown, other than for their famous dad. That is, until Kim's controversial intimate tape with Ray J leaked in 2003. We know, the controversy still isn't ending. Did Kim leak the tape herself? It was known that Kim always wanted to be famous, and she essentially became famous for being famous, a catch-22 that she made work very well for herself. So who knows, maybe momager Kris and herself, Kimmy, had a plan. Or maybe she was unfortunately revealed beyond what she wanted. Whichever it was, it led the family to great success in a roundabout way. Her two younger sisters, Courtney and Khloe, quickly caught up on the fame train with the success of the reality show. Prior to Keeping Up with the Kardashians, the sisters were already entrepreneurs, or at least trying to be. They opened up the retail fashion store Dash in 2006. The store lasted quite a long time, despite it being rough at the beginning. But in 2018, after some crazy successful years for all the Kardashian-Jenner sisters, it was time to close the boutiques. The Jenner sisters were incredibly young when Keeping Up with the Kardashians first aired on E! News, October 14, 2007. They weren't anywhere near the supermodel status or cosmetic mogul status which they hold today. Nonetheless, their antics, energy, and hilarious arguments garnered them a lot of attention. The Jenner sisters at a young age were charismatic and endearing. They brought a fun youth to the show, and neither of them wasted their opportunity at fame. Instead, they fostered it into crazy successful lives of their own outside the very famous reality show they grew up on. Unlike their half-sisters, the Jenners had slightly more luxury in terms of already having a name. That doesn't mean these talented girls didn't work hard. Oh no, it seems like they may have even worked harder because of their fame. The Jenners seem to want to set themselves apart from their sisters. Since being on the show, the girls never struggled with a boutique clothing line or an embarrassing leaked tape, but they did have to grow up in the spotlight, a challenge of its own. What sort of teenager wants a camera in their face constantly while she's going through changes? We've got to give these gals major props for facing fame with courage and class. Not only did they grow up to have their own lives aside from the reality show, but they also started to be compared to their older sisters. They were clearly becoming a match for the famous Kardashians. They may even be giving them a run for their money. With all the Jenner success packed into two gals, and competing against the biggest name in the game, the Kardashian trio, the question, who did it better, is going to be hard to answer. Hard times. In 2003, the Kardashian sisters went through a terrible loss when their father, Rob, passed away, leaving the family in grief. Khloe reflected on this time, remembering that after losing her dad, she was partying way too hard and sleeping in every morning. Since then, she has really turned her life around. But who can blame the girl? Not us. That the three sisters were strong enough to deal with such a loss and still come out on top by opening a store prior to becoming world famous is a huge success in itself. However, that isn't the only time the Kardashian trio had to face hard times. Besides the obvious family ups and downs that we all see on their various reality shows, they have also dealt with some very difficult situations. To start, when Kim was robbed in Paris. It was an experience no one should ever face, but the family, despite allegations they may have done it for the press, which, in our opinion, just a crazy accusation, they dealt with it professionally. In 2007, Khloe was stopped for a DUI and held in custody for 3 hours before being released. The family didn't deal with this scandal as well as the others. In fact, it was apparently reenacted to be shown on the reality show, which fans weren't too happy about. Then there's Courtney's tumultuous relationship with baby daddy Scott Disick, which we have to say has recently seemed to be going swimmingly. Sure, his new supermodel girlfriend Sofia Richie may be stirring a few pots, but seeing as they all went on vacation together, we'd say that the bad news about this couple ended long ago. As for the Jenners, these ladies have faced some of their own hard times too, except they're more controversial than just hard. We all love a good controversy, especially when it involves the Jenners. Kendall was taking the modeling world by storm and breaking away from her reality star roots when some things seriously hit the fan, like that Pepsi commercial. Certainly, Kendall was excited to be starring in an iconic Pepsi ad. That is, until the ad was interpreted as making fun of the Black Lives Matter movement. And, of course, because Kendall is a member of one of the world's most famous families, she immediately got called out and caught up in the controversy. Kendall has expressed how awful the backlash was on Keeping Up with the Kardashians. The unfortunate thing is that it took a while for the negativity around her to go away. There was also the Vogue ballerina shoot where she got backlash because she should have let a real ballerina be hired. This was another super unfortunate controversy for the model, but this lady still came out on top. However, in 2019, Kendall was plagued with yet another small backlash. What seemed to be a personal story she posted actually wound up being no more than a paid sponsorship for the model. Kris Jenner teased the announcement by describing Kendall as vulnerable and brave, sharing her most raw story for positive impact. Many fans speculated what Kendall could have possibly been referring to when she made the statement, "I want to help people." When it was finally revealed that Kendall was simply referring to acne, fans were disappointed. To make matters worse, news spread that it was just a paid advertisement by the acne skincare company Proactive. Once again, not the greatest look for the model. Still, she was just doing her job, wasn't she? Kylie, on the other hand, seems to be the least controversial of the two sisters, except for that time when the duo decided to make t-shirts. Kylie and Kendall took rocker tees with bands like The Doors and Kiss on them and put their faces over them. Of course. This turned into a major lawsuit because the girls didn't get permission to use the famous images. Overall, both groups of girls have gone through a lot, both personally and professionally. With Caitlyn Jenner's transition in April 2015, it proved to us that the ladies can conduct themselves with grace, acceptance, and love most of the time. Khloé bought Caitlyn white Christian Louboutin stilettos after her transition. We know. We want some, too. Kim gushed about how beautiful she looked, and Kylie called her an angel on earth. The list goes on, but basically, no matter the amount of challenging situations this family faces, they always seem to come out on top. Speaking of top, the time has come to let the sibling rivalry continue in the realm of makeup and other entrepreneurial endeavors. And we all know that when it comes to cosmetics, the Kardashian Jenners do it best. Accomplishments and the cosmetic war. Okay, we get it. The Kardashian clan loves, and we mean loves, cosmetics. There's a darn good reason for it, too. They're so good at it. Not only with how they apply it, but also how they sell it. These women aren't just another pretty makeup-enhanced face. Oh no. These ladies are big boss entrepreneurs. Kim Kardashian started her makeup brand, KKW Beauty, in June 2017 after collaborating on her half-sister's brand, Kylie Cosmetics, with four nude lip kits. Kim got the taste for it and didn't look back. Now KKW has become Kim's most lucrative endeavor yet. However, lately, Kim has been accused of copying Kylie's brand in different ways, from eye color palettes to lip liners and lip colors. The claims are hard to ignore, considering the proof is in the product. There are just a whole lot of similarities. Perhaps Kim is just inspired by her sister's brand, which we have to admit is sweet. KKW Beauty brought in over $100 million to Kim's net worth by July 2018, approximately only 1 year after it was launched. She also owns 100% of it, because Kim is a lady of business and she knows what the right move is. It was Kylie Jenner who actually paved the way for a successful cosmetic business in the Kardashian household. She also did it as a teenager, and now in her early 20s, she's reaping the benefits big time. There were, of course, many failed Kardashian brands, but it's KKW Beauty, Kylie Cosmetics, and Good American that are thriving. So yes, Kylie founded a makeup empire, which made her the richest of all the sisters in a very short amount of time. Kylie started the company in 2015, and by 2018, it was well on its way to becoming a billion-dollar company. Her Kylie lip lip kits were a marketing hit and sold out immediately. Kylie has been criticized by some for using her fame, where others think it's just business wisdom. The only thing about this whole cosmetic empire between the sisters is that it's actually confusing to some fans. Many fans have revealed that they feel frustrated over the sister rivalry. If they support and love both sisters, who do they ultimately choose to buy from? In 2017, Kim and Kylie had a feud over the competition, which apparently resulted in Kylie not showing up for Kim's birthday. Well, needless to say, these two hardworking gals have the cosmetic industry cornered. Kim has, however, seemed to conveniently release similar products as Kylie, from red lip colors to the same eye palette. Do you think Kim is copying Kylie? Good American has become a recognized and highly successful denim brand co-founded by Khloe Kardashian. The Body Positive denim line was launched alongside co-founder Emma Greed in October 2016. The line made $1 million on the day of its launch, the biggest denim apparel launch in history. Khloe has her own business savvy upper sleeves as well. As for Kendall Jenner, she's a bit of the black sheep of the family and in all the right ways. She veered away from reality TV in a big way and has since made herself into the highest paid model in the world. Sure, as we've mentioned, she's faced her own fair share of controversies in the industry, but she's also had massive success. Kendall has walked the most sought after runways in the world, been on countless magazine covers, and modeled for some of the most respected designers in fashion. In 2015, Kendall made her debut with Victoria's Secret, an honor any model would want. We'll get more into fashion and trendsetting in this fierce competition soon, so stick around to see who does it better. Wealth. When it comes to wealth, these ladies pretty much make it rain 24/7. Should we just end it right there? We think not. In 2019, we got the estimated net worth of our five leading ladies. We're sure you already know who was on top. Yep, it's our youngest woman, Kylie Jenner. Seeing as she was on the cover of Forbes in August 2018 with the title America's Women Billionaires, it's pretty clear that Kylie is worth the most out of the family in 2019. She may have only been a teen when she started Kylie Cosmetics in 2015, but by 2018 she was already at the top as one of the youngest female billionaires. Next in line is Kim Kardashian West, who was also featured in Forbes in 2018 as one of the richest self-made women. With KKW Beauty and her other endeavors, Kim is worth $350 million in 2019. Following Kim is Khloe. With her Good American denim line and her executive producing ventures, she is estimated at $40 million. This number also includes her Keeping Up with the Kardashians salary and endorsements. Kourtney follows her sister closely with $35 million net worth for her reality TV salary and, of course, her numerous endorsement deals. Last is Kendall Jenner, who may be the quote-unquote poorest of the group, but she's still majorly loaded. Kendall sits at a comfortable $18 million and has been named the highest paid model in the world for 2 years running. So all these ladies are absolutely crushing it. But what sister team ranks number one? With the Jenners bookending the Kardashians' net worth, it's just too hard to say. Let's just leave this one at a draw, shall we? Social media craze. Just like their net worth, the social media follows these gals have is, well, astronomical. But who takes home the cake as the most social media crazed girl? Let's take a look at the numbers to determine if the Jenners or the Kardashians come out on top. In 2019, Kim had a whopping 126 million followers on Instagram. Khloe has 86.2 million, and Kourtney has 73.1 million. As for the Jenners, Kylie matches Kim at 126 million followers, while Kendall follows closely behind at 103 million followers. Now, we've got to say that the Jenners win this round. Not only are they only two sisters, but they both have the highest followers, other than Kim, who ties for first place. Of course, these numbers will always fluctuate, but the younger sisters take the lead in this round. Fashion icons. The old who wore better has been a question for the ages, especially with the Kardashians versus the Jenners. Kim and Kendall seem to both rock the red carpet with fierce fashion choices and bold poses. So who does it better? They each have iconic moments in the fashion world, and Kendall, being a model, definitely has her practice and expertise in fashion. But then again, Kim has always been a fashion icon to watch and imitate. Their red carpet duel isn't going to end anytime soon. Both are brave with their style choices. At the Chopard Secret Night Party in 2018, Kendall hit the red carpet with a sheer green dress, leaving nothing to the imagination. While still looking classy, Kim had her own iconic look at the 2018 Met Gala when she wore a gold, skin-tight, floor-length Versace dress. Now, these moments go on and on. Kim has always been a fashion icon, but Kendall, since becoming a model, has matched her older sister outfit for outfit. Kim did almost break the internet with a fashion photo shoot back in 2014 where she wore no clothes. Do you know which picture we're talking about? Yeah, we figured. The iconic champagne balanced on booty picture. If you're a fashionista who can still bring style without clothes, that's pretty top-notch. Kendall is sure to have her own iconic internet-breaking moment herself one day. Who do you think rocks the red carpet harder with their iconic looks, Kim or Kendall? So which celeb siblings have the fashion industry cornered? It seems like they both bring great styles to the table. Which sisters do you take fashion inspiration from more? Personal life. The Kardashians' personal lives are packed full of kids, relationships, new homes, and of course, scandals. From Kourtney and Scott's tumultuous relationship to claims of Tristan Thompson cheating on Khloe, the Kardashians are no strangers to heartbreak. The ladies have been through their ups and downs with Kim's 72-day marriage to Chris Humphries and Khloe's divorce from Lamar in 2016 after having their own reality show together. Kim and Kanye have three children together and are currently looking for places to buy in the Bahamas and other locations. According to TMZ, they pulled $14 million out of an exclusive Miami condo and are returning to the luxury real estate market once again. Kourtney and Scott are currently in a good family dynamic once Kourtney officially called it quits after years of being on and off. Khloe has her baby, True Thompson, and is working hard at her business. The Kardashian household is full, and we mean full, of little adorable ones running around. The Jenners' personal lives have pretty much always been in the spotlight. Kylie did go through a bit of a hard time breaking up with Tyga after rumors of his infidelity, but now Kylie is happy with Astroworld rapper Travis Scott, and we can't get enough of that couple. The two had a beautiful baby, Stormy Webster, and Kylie even revealed her beautiful California home in Architectural Digest in early 2019. We got to see her pink rooms, neon lights, and very stylish decor. Kendall, on the other hand, is focusing on her career. However, there have been longtime rumors of her sexual orientation. Kendall stated to Vogue back in 2018 that she has nothing to hide and that she's not gay. Then, in January 2019, when all the hype made by Chris about Kendall revealing something brave wasn't about her sexual orientation, but instead about proactive skin products, fans were disappointed. In early 2019, Kendall has been allegedly dating Ben Simmons, shutting down those rumors. The five ladies are clearly taking the world by storm and have been for a long time. How could we ever decide who wins the duel between the two groups of sisters? Guess you'll just have to decide for yourself. Which set of sisters do you think does it better? The Kardashian trio or the Jenner duo? Let us know all your thoughts on this famous family's fierce competition in the comment section. Subscribe to The Taco and give this video a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.